Alright, hello everyone and welcome back to Cuddabo Space Program, where today we are having a look at yet another wonderful mod, this time in the form of the Kerbal Planetary Base System, which is being made by forum user Nils277, and what this glorious little piece of work looks to add into the game is a whole large selection of new, fun, wonderful parts for building bases on planetary surfaces, and that is just glorious. I mean, already in the game, we have a lot of cool parts for building space stations, but whenever you went to go and build things on planetary surfaces, say for instance, a moon base, it kinda got weird using cylindrical space station parts to build something on a flat surface. So in comes the Kerbal Planetary Base System to give you more options, and the best part for me is they are stock alike. I am a sucker for a stock alike mod, so let's jump into the Space Plane Hangar, as it is easier to view them in here than in the VAB, as these parts are meant to be going onto a flat surface, so why not check them out in here? Now, the first three parts that we get added in are three fun new command pods, the first of which we'll look at is the K&K Planetary Cupola, which, there we go, is a lovely little command pod there, nice big gigantic windows. Currently no IVA, but that will be coming soon. Same for this command module here. Again, no IVA for right now, but that will be coming down the road. And then the last command pod that we have here is a automated control pod, which fits right in line with all of the parts. And as you can see, they're all nicely flat bottom so that they can nicely fit or land on a planetary surface without much rolling around like a normal cylindrical part would. And it's quite nice, quite convenient, and a very cool design. Now, as for these three command pods, the cupola here is designed for only a single Kerbal, does have a nice little electrical charge at 150, and it does have a science experiment of a crew report, of course, and a small reaction wheel. Now, the other command pod, minimum of one crew, but holds a maximum of two. Same crew report, of course, and reaction wheel. Very good. And finally, the automated one has a reaction wheel, SAS, and electric charge at 250. Very nice, three little command pods, very useful. Now, we do have things in fuel tanks, we do have things in engines, but I'm going to hold off on looking at those until we cover a few more things. Nothing in command and control, but down here in structural, if we just take off this other command pod, we have a whole mess of parts for building your lovely little planetary base. We have a whole selection of gangway points that you can use to connect your different modules for your new planetary base. So let's start here with the cross gangway. Very nice little four-way cross here. Very good, very convenient. We then have a six-ended gangway, which goes in every direction possible. And then we have a five-ended gangway that goes in almost every direction except for the bottom. We then have a four-ended one, which goes everywhere but the bottom and side. We then have a three-ended one, which, let's pop it. Oh boy. There. Excellent. Which has only three endpoints, so good for a corner piece, perhaps. Very intriguing indeed. And then after that, we have a gangway airlock, which of course you pop onto the end of one of your gangways, and you can then leave the station from this point. Very convenient and handy to have. We also have a gangway ending point, which, if you don't want an airlock, you can just get a nice little rounded bubble thing at the end. Very cool indeed. We then have a T-shaped gangway, so you can split off a nice little extra gangway from between two points and send down another hallway. We then have a two-ended turn gangway. Oh boy, where to fit this one? Oh god. Rotate it correctly. Good enough. There we go. Nice little corner piece. And then, of course, we have a straight haul gangway. So we have the two-ended gangway right here, which will pop there. And then a longer gangway right there. Excellent. So various sizes, shapes, etc. And then finally, we have a planetary adapter, which is quite cool. It may not be a gangway like all of these various parts, but this is a very interesting and useful one. This is meant to go between various modules, and it does have the ability to hold liquid fuel and oxidizer, but its main purpose is you see these side panels here that are nice and flat compared to the typically rounded nature of, say, the cupola module. This is a nice flat surface so that you can put onto this perhaps engines or landing legs, etc. So if you do want a little bit of extra support or engine power, you can slap those right onto the side and you have a nice straight surface to attach them to. Very cool. And as I said, does hold a little bit of liquid fuel and oxidizer. And then, of course, while we're here, you do notice that on this little piece, all of the gangway parts connect nicely into the little circular ends, and it's the same deal from the cupola module and the other command pod. You have the nice little circular bits that the different gangways fit right into. Let's actually lose all of you. That's just so many different gangway parts, but it's glorious, oh so glorious, so many parts to make your perfect base. Nothing in aerodynamics. Then in utility is where we find the vast majority of other parts. We have, for instance, the planetary habitat, which we can pop here, and unfortunately, it does actually deploy. Right now, even though it is a habitat, we cannot put Kerbals into it because it's closed up. When you're outside of the space plan hangar, you can deploy this into a larger unit, and that's when you can then put Kerbals inside of it. But for right now, it is basically just a battery, essentially, with 200 electrical charge. And then eventually can hold Kerbals. We also have a planetary greenhouse, which is much larger, and similarly to the habitat, this cannot have Kerbals inside of it until it deploys. But once it deploys, you can put Kerbals in here, and they will use the greenhouse as it should be used. And this currently is compatible with the USI life support system, but the mod maker is working to make it compatible with other life support systems as well. Now, I have no life support system installed, so it can still be used, but it's essentially just a blank greenhouse then that does nothing but look pretty, and oh boy, is it pretty inside. These two things, the habitat and the greenhouse, are at the moment the only things that have internal views, and they're gorgeous. We'll get to looking at those in a bit. As I said, the other internal views they are working on, but it will take a little bit more time to get to them. So let's take off just the greenhouse there. We then have a lovely planetary service bay, which works exactly the same as the other service bays in the game. Oh my god, cooperate with me, please. There we go, green. And you just open up this, and you can pop in all sorts of scientific experiments, etc. on the inside. I do like that we have one of these little service bays in the new shape of the planetary base system here. Very nice indeed. And then, probably one of the most important pieces, in my opinion, we have this modular storage rack system, which is gorgeous. Now, this is why we didn't look at the fuel tanks yet, because this storage system is where these fuel tanks go into. Now, we have a battery right here ready to go, and if we click this, the battery fits into one of those cargo slots, and it's the same thing with things in fuel tanks. So we can actually come over here now, and in here we have a liquid fuel tank, which can go here and carries 200 liquid fuel. We have an RCS fuel tank, which can click right in there. We then have the RCS fuel tank, I should mention, 400 monopropellant. We then have a ore container, which takes up a single slot. There we go. We also have a fuel container that holds both liquid fuel and oxidizer at 90 liquid fuel, 110 oxidizer. That can click right in there. And then the last two pieces are double versions of the liquid fuel container, this was the fuel container with liquid fuel and oxidizer, just a double version, so it takes up two slots. And same with the ore container, we have a double version of that as well. I do like that you have all those various options. It is quite cool. I really, really love this system. Because it's no just large fuel tanks that are shaped like these things. They click right on into this little cargo system. I absolutely love it. So let's click all those off. Click over there and then go back into utility, as there are a few more parts, two to be specific. We then have a docking port, which we can click. Oh god, no, that didn't work quite right. There we go. A docking port that you can click onto your planetary base. And I actually just realized that's backwards. Hold on. There we go. Yes, that's far more correct. Excellent. So if you have a similar one of these, you can dock right onto it and you are good to go. We then also have a gangway docking port, which fits on, of course, to the gangways, or can be put on any of the radial surfaces and functions the same as any other docking port. You just clamp right on and you're good to go. Very, very cool indeed. That's it for utility. So the last two pages, science and then back to the engines. So in the science tab, we have this KK Planetary Laboratory, which again currently doesn't have an IVA, and it is another one of those deployable structures, just like the habitat module or the greenhouse. They are very, very cool modules, and it works just the same as the other science lab. Very cool indeed. I love this thing. Gorgeous. And now, finally, engines. I didn't want to look at that until we looked at the fuel tanks, because, well, engines need fuel. And this comes with a very, very cool Meerkat landing assist system. It works, fits in line with the design of these planetary base structures, and has, on the bottom of it, as you can see here, two lovely little engine nozzles. Very, very cool design. I love the modeling on this, because, yeah, it's just a cool little engine inset into it. Now, it also does have these straight sides that you could put, say, landing gear or something like that onto it, just like that One Piece Instructural did. It does also hold liquid fuel and oxidizer, has a gimbling, and of course you can change the thrust limiter just like you can with anything. So if you want to actually land your whole constructed base, you theoretically can. Now, I was playing around earlier with actually trying to make some sort of dropship with that thing. So far, I haven't been able to successfully fly it, but it's a potential use for this system. I've got two of these little Meerkat engines, a storage container system, and then RCS battery and a little engine. A horribly crappy little plane, but you know what? It's a possibility of how to use these parts beyond just building bases. Very, very cool little shuttle. I have yet to get it to fly. It keeps flipping and blowing itself up. But next, let's actually look at the two IVAs that we do have in the game currently, which are just gorgeous. I set up a little IVA test out here. And so what we need to do to actually get Kerbals into these, so for instance, if we try to currently transfer one of our Kerbals, we cannot put them into the habitat or the greenhouse, because, well, they're not deployed yet, as I mentioned earlier. So what you have to do is actually physically deploy them, and they open up, stretching themselves out to create a larger base, and oh, look at that beautiful, beautiful little deployed base. I absolutely love these things. We can turn the lights on, so, you know, there's lights, which is always nice to have. Very cool. And now we can transfer, say, Bill over here, and we can transfer Bob over into the greenhouse. So let's take a look at Bill over in the habitat bay, and oh, look at this. It's just so cool. It's like a little dorm. It's very awesome. We have these food and snacks, water, that little note over there, kind of blurry, but it says hands off Jeb. Over there, we have a picture of the crew. Very nice. And then in the back, the different rooms in the habitat module. And of course, a note to call the Kerbal Space Center next to the lovely TV. I just love the look of this place. It is just beautiful. It's, I think, honestly, one of my favorite IVAs. It's just so cool. It looks like a little dorm room for your Kerbals. Now, next, we have Bob, and he is inside the greenhouse. Look at this. This is just beautiful. You've got all the plants scattered around. Very, very cool. You've got the watering plants here. I love this. Bill, he's got plenty. Val's watered plenty. Bob, oh, but poor Jeb. He's only watered the plants once. Oh, dear Jebediah, you have been skipping out on your work. It is an absolutely gorgeous little IVA view in here. I absolutely love this thing. So I cannot wait to see if these are the two IVAs that we currently have. I cannot wait to see what the mod maker does with the other three IVAs that are currently planned. Ah, it's beautiful. I absolutely adore it. That's enough of those IVAs. Let us actually go to the Space Center and check out a just quick, crappy little base I put on the moon earlier. Of course, using HyperEdit to expedite things. And to show off what one of these bases could possibly look like if you actually put some effort into it. Now, I literally constructed this thing in about 10 minutes in the space plane hangar and then, you know, cheated it up here with HyperEdit, but if you actually took the time to build a proper base and get it onto the moon, you could have something that looks much, much better than this. I mean, it's a perfectly functional base with nice little greenhouse back here that could provide food for them if you have a life support system installed, a beautiful habitat where they can go and rest, the cool cupola module, which I cannot wait to see the internal view of down the road for control of everything, and this lovely laboratory here for all the science. We've got a nice little selection of cargo pods here. We have in the service bay our communication antenna there that's just folding itself up, and a surface scan module for ores. I forgot to put a drill on this thing, but we do have an ore container. Just, it was so easy to build this little module or modular base. So just imagine with some actual effort the cool things you could build with this. And with all of the different gangway options, you could spread this thing out over just dozens and dozens of little areas the same size as this, just continuously working your way out. And it's just, it's beautiful. I really love this. All the parts look stock alike, which just makes me happy. And I love that little detail, the little telescope that deploys on the laboratory. It's just so cool. It's such a wonderful mod. And I really do hope that you guys go and check this out, because I gotta say, I've looked at a lot of mods at my time of doing these videos. This is one of my favorite, just because these parts are so gorgeous. And building bases on planets is one of my favorite things to do. As you know, I'm not a good pilot, so I love to build. And this just makes my day. So I hope you guys check it out and have fun with it and enjoy yourself, hopefully building some beautiful beautiful planetary base stations. And if you do, tweet me a picture of them. I would love to see what sort of creativity you guys have out there and what you could do with these parts. And yeah, I hope you have enjoyed this video today, and of course that you come back for the next. But until then, thank you for watching, my friends, and as always, have a good one.